This is part 47, and we have started that part of the general exceptions where there is incapacity on the part of an individual to do an act which amounts to an offense. Maybe the first group of the sections with which we dealt, section 82 and section 83, which deals with act of a child as a defense. The child is incapable of doing an act which amounts to an offense because of his state of the mind. Namely, as his state of the mind is such that it is not possible for him to distinguish between right and wrong. If one cannot distinguish between right and wrong, you cannot attribute criminal intention to the act which is done on the part of that person. And the act which is done on the part of such a person is not at all made punishable by the provisions of the criminal law in the absence of criminal intention. That will not amount to an offense. And hence, we dealt with, if you remember, during the last part 46, we dealt with two sections, namely section 82, which lays down nothing is an offense which is done by a child under 7 years of age, and section 83, which says nothing is an offense which is done by a child above 7 years of age and under 12 who has not attained sufficient maturity of understanding to judge of the nature and the consequences of his conduct on that occasion. Once the child is above the age of 12 years, it is possible for the child to distinguish between right and wrong. But then, as long as child doesn't become major, he is not dealt by the provisions of ordinary criminal law. He is never taken before a court of judicial magistrate first class constituted as per the provisions of the criminal procedure code. No, but in that case, such a child who is child means below 18 years of age, maybe irrespective of the nature of the sex, whether male or female, is governed by the provisions of the Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Act of 2000 as far as criminal law is concerned. When you refer to age of majority as far as civil law is concerned, naturally you go by the provisions of the Indian Majority Act. And then Indian Majority Act was enacted in the year 1875, but because of the amendment to this act in the year 1999, today the age as far as majority is concerned, one who attains the age of 18 years irrespective of anything becomes major as per the provisions. Now this you can go on learning simultaneously along with learning the provisions of the criminal law. So don't have watertight compartment as far as criminal law is concerned, civil law is concerned, but then you go on learning and then you can have what is known as holistic approach from the point of view of understanding the provisions of the law. With this now, the person who is a person of unsound mind stands on the same footing as that of a child who is under 7 years of age, or the child who is above 7 years of age and who is under 12 years of age who has not attained sufficient maturity of understanding to judge of the nature and the consequences of his conduct on that particular occasion. Namely, there is an incapacity on his part to commit an offense. And for that, this is exactly what we try to understand as to what do you mean by insanity as a defense. In order to understand this, we shall be dealing with only one section, namely section 84 of the Indian Penal Code. And then when we talk about insanity as a defense, immediately you will look into the section and raise objection. Sir, insanity is the term which is nowhere used as far as section 84 is concerned. It speaks about a person's unsoundness of mind, that is person of unsound mind. But then, I mean, the heading of the section says act of a person of unsound mind. But then why it is that the sir has referred to this insanity as a defense? This is generally everywhere known as per the law laid down by the Supreme Court, as per the law laid down by the High Court, and as per the understanding of this particular topic, this is this is person who is a person of unsound mind. Now, person of unsound mind is nowhere defining the law. In other words, person can be said to be a person of unsound mind when he is not of sound mind. And what do you mean by a person of sound mind? Who knows the natural and probable consequences of the act which is done by him? He has got the power to judge What are the consequences of the act that is done by him? He has capacity. So, in other words, person of unsound mind is a person who has got lost control over the mind. In other words, it is not possible for him to know what he is doing. He is not in a position to understand the natural and probable consequences of the act which is done by him. There are various terms which are used to describe taking into consideration the state of the mind of an individual. For example, idiot, mad, mental derangement, mental disorder, lunatic, insane person are the various terms that are used. But all the terms meaning is what? Meaning is that he is a person of unsound mind. Now, when person of unsound, is it that every person who is a person of unsound mind is protected as far as section 84 of the Indian Penal Code is concerned? The answer is in the negative. It is not every person who is a person of unsound mind. And then how you decide whether a person is a person of sound mind or unsound mind? By merely looking at a person, it is not possible for you to find out whether the person is a person of sound mind or person is a person of unsound mind. And hence, whenever you want to know from the point of view of law whether the person is a person of sound mind or person is a person of unsound mind, naturally he is taken to the doctor. And it is the certificate after he carries out the examination which plays very important role in order to determine whether he is a person of sound mind or whether he is a person of unsound mind. During course of time, when you shall be dealing with the provisions of the criminal procedure code, you will come to know if a person is a person of unsound mind at the time of the trial, it may not be possible for the court of law to observe the principles of natural justice, namely right to hear and to be heard. And hence, right from section 328 up to section 339 of the criminal procedure code are the sections which deal with what? Which deals with provisions regarding person of unsound mind. And the general principle is followed, laid down as far as these sections are concerned. If it is found that during the course of the trial, the person was a person of unsound mind or person is a person of unsound mind, the trial is adjourned or postponed till he becomes a person of sound mind. So whether he was of unsound mind, a certificate is required to be given by the doctor. Whether he is a person of sound mind, the certificate is required to be given again by the doctor. The doctor is required to be examined by the court of law, and after conducting inquiry, if the court comes to the conclusion, yes, now he is a person. But here, as far as the Indian, this is just by way of information, but as far as Indian Penal Code is concerned, it deals with what? When the act is done by the person who was a person of unsound mind. And in order to understand the importance of this particular section, as usual, we proceed with illustrations. One, there was after death of a father, he had four sons, and property was required to be inherited among the four sons equally as per the personal law. But the eldest of all thought had sort of a criminal conspiracy between other two so as to deprive the youngest of the right to have a claim with respect to the property of the father. And then by that time he was also a person of the youngest one was person of unsound mind. He was, treated by the psychiatrist, no doubt about it. But ultimately, the circumstances compelled them to admit him to the mental asylum for the purpose of medical treatment. This youngest son always had in his mind that my eldest brother wants to deprive me of the share of which I inherit as far as my father's property is concerned. And then every now and then he used to say, well, I want to take revenge. He is depriving me of my property. Why he was in the mental asylum also? Now, why he was in the mental asylum? He was in the mental asylum because after examination, doctor came to the conclusion that he was a person of unsound mind and he needed treatment very badly. So he was undergoing a treatment. While I mean talking to everybody in the mental asylum, he used to say, my brother wants to deprive me of my property, but I won't allow him to do so. Let me get an opportunity. As soon as I get an opportunity, I will teach him a lesson. And one day, unfortunately for the eldest brother, this brother who was in the mental asylum escaped from the mental asylum, went to the market, got a knife, went to the eldest brother and stabbed him or killed him, hence committed the offense of murder defined by section 300 of the Indian Penal Code. When this younger son was, or brother was arrested by the police, his defense at the time of the trial was that, well, I was a person of unsound mind when the act was done by him, and hence the question of criminal liability doesn't arise. There was incapacity on my part to do an act which amounts to an offense, hence I am not liable. What is his liability is the question for our consideration. This is one illustration. The second illustration, please do remember the sequence of the illustration from the point of view of understanding section 84 very clearly. In the second illustration, two friends who were residing in the same room, they were roommates in the hostel, A and B, went outside and came during night hours. After they came back and wished each other a good night and wanted to go to sleep, Mr. A had become a person of unsound mind. Mr. B was enjoying a sound sleep, but A, whatever may be the reason, Mr. A had impact as far as their visit outside was concerned, because of which he had lost control over the mind and he could not enjoy the sleep, and he started looking at his friend Mr. B, who was enjoying sleep very quietly, that he is enjoying sleep now, I can't have sleep. What will happen if I separate his head from the body? Not only that, he actually implemented the idea, separated head from the body. The head was kept on the top of the cupboard and he started looking once at a body and once at a head by saying how it will be possible for him to manage his affairs when he gets up early in the morning tomorrow. In the meantime, it so happened this matter went to the rector, it was reported to the police and he was arrested on the accusation of murder, and he wanted to raise a defense that, well, I am not false under section
84 of the Indian Penal Code. This is the second illustration. The third illustration, a person went to a temple of Kali Mata. He had a sword in his hand, came back. And after coming back, he said, Kali Mata ki jai, killed one person. After killing one person, he said, Kali Mata ki jai, and killed another person. After saying Kali Mata ki jai, he killed third person. By that time, everybody realized and they were asking, what are you doing? Is it good on your part? And then he said, well, I am doing not wrong. I am just obeying the orders given by Kali Mata. And he also raised the sword with respect to one who asked him the question, but he was not, and he was taken up by the mob to the police, and he was charged for the offense of murder. What is his liability? All persons take it for granted, for the sake of argument, for the timing, as per the medical examination which was carried out by the doctor certified that they were those persons who had done the act, namely the youngest brother to one who was residing or who was roommate, who were residing in the same hostel, and thirdly, one who went to the temple of Kali Mata. Once it is certified by the doctor, when the matter went to the court of law and they were sent for the purpose of medical examination, this clearly indicates that they, all of them, were person of unsound mind. Yes. And once it is certified by the doctor, they were person of unsound mind, naturally you can say that they were suffering because of what is known as medical insanity. But even though they were suffering because of medical insanity, or they were having medical insanity, mind well, in order that they should get protection as far as Section 84 of the Indian Penal Code is concerned. It's not that they should suffer because of only medical insanity. They should also suffer because of what is known as legal insanity. Now, these are the terms you don't convey anywhere by reading Section 84. But if you are reading of Section 84, which says nothing is an offense which is done by a person who, at the time of doing it, by reason of unsoundness of mind, is incapable of knowing the nature of the act or that he is doing what is either wrong or contrary to law. So, person was a person of unsound mind. Who can certify? It is the certificate that is issued by the doctor. But in addition to that, when the evidence is recorded by the court of law, court will take into consideration what was his behavior prior to the act that was done by him, what was his behavior at the time when the act was done by him, and what was his subsequent behavior. And by taking into consideration his behavior prior to, at the time of, and subsequent behavior, if the court comes to the conclusion, yes, he was incapable of knowing the nature of the act, then naturally what the court will say, because of the fact that he was, his state of the mind was such, in other words, he had reached that degree of unsoundness of mind, because of which he was incapable of knowing the nature of the act, then the court will certify, or court will say that he was suffering because of what is known as legal insanity. And if a person suffers because of legal insanity, he is protected as far as Section 84 of the Indian Penal Code is concerned. Now, this to understand incapable of knowing the nature of the act, do remember second illustration where the person, for example, attacked the person, Mr. A, who was, residing in a hostel room, thought that he should separate the head from the body, and what he was doing, he was incapable of knowing the nature of that. Otherwise, if he would have been in a position to know the nature of that, or if his intention was to commit the offense of murder defined by Section 300 of the Indian Penal Code, what he would have done? He would have done secretly. Generally, this is psychology of the criminal, barring few exceptions, that they act secretly and try to run away from the particular place. So this is, as when he was controlled, when he was examined by the doctor, when he was asked by those who were in the hostel over there, the court judge came to the conclusion that he had taken into consideration his behavior prior to, at the time, and subsequent behavior. Throughout night, after separating head from the body, he was looking at the head, looking at the body. What does it indicate? It clearly indicates that he was incapable of knowing the nature of the act, and hence such a person is protected as far as Section 84 of the Indian Penal Code is concerned. The person, as far as the third illustration is concerned, he was capable of knowing the nature of the act that he was killing Kali Mata Ki Jai, one person, Kali Mata Ki Jai, by raising sword and giving cut with the head, with the help of the sword. He was knowing that he is going to kill somebody. So he was, in case where the person is capable of knowing the nature of the act, but in such a situation, the second part of the section says, at the time of doing it by reason of unsoundness of mind, is incapable of knowing the nature of the act, that is, as far as if the person, as far as the first, second illustration is concerned, and that he is doing what is either wrong or contrary to the law. So if it is found out by the court of law that he was incapable of knowing that the thing that he is doing what is either wrong or contrary to the law, by killing he is doing a wrong act. By killing, he is committing murder. What reply was given? I am doing nothing wrong. I am obeying the orders which are given by Mata. So what does it indicate? He was knowing that he was killing somebody, but he was not knowing that he was doing the thing which was wrong or contrary to the law. And hence, in the second illustration and third illustration, as the court can come to the conclusion that the accused was suffering because of what is known as legal insanity, he is protected. In other words, legal insanity includes medical insanity, but medical insanity does not necessarily include legal insanity. A person may be a person of unsound mind, yes, no doubt about it. But what should be the nature of degree of unsoundness of mind? The person must be incapable of knowing the nature of the act or that he is doing what is either wrong or contrary to the law. Then only is protected as far as section 84 of the Indian Penal Code is concerned, otherwise not. And hence, this is what is meant by act of a person of unsound mind. With this, now we come to the first illustration. The person who was admitted to the mental asylum for the purpose of treatment, every now and then used to say, well, let me get an opportunity and I will kill my brother, I will teach him a lesson because he wants to deprive me of my share as far as my father's ancestral property is concerned, or the property which is required to be inherited by me is concerned as a matter of right as per the personal law. He killed him. Now, because of the fact that he was a person of unsound mind, that was the reason why he was admitted to the hospital, which clearly indicates that he was suffering because of medical insanity. But this clearly shows he was waiting for an opportunity. He was telling everybody he was capable of knowing the nature of the act, and hence he had not reached that degree because of which he was incapable of knowing the nature of the act, or that he was doing was either wrong or contrary to the law. It cannot be said that he was suffering because of what is known as legal insanity, and hence he is not at all protected as far as section 84 of the Indian Penal Code is concerned, and he cannot get benefit as far as section 84 of the Indian Penal Code is concerned. Now, this is the gist of section 84, or as you go on reading the various cases that come before the court of law, the court will take into consideration that it's a question of evidence, mind well, and once court comes to the conclusion, one, that he was a person of unsound mind, for which a certificate of doctor is required to be examined, and then the court will follow the procedure which is laid down as far as Indian Evidence Act is concerned, experts evidence, right from section 45 onwards of the Indian Evidence Act. Yes, correct. In addition to that, while recording the evidence as far as whether he should be protected, because here the burden of proof as per section 105 of the Indian Evidence Act lies on the accused person to prove, and what he has to prove, because of the fact that my case falls under section 84, he will admit the act that is done by him, and he will say that, well, it is an exception to the section with which I am charged, because what section 84 says, nothing is an offense which is done by a person who at the time of doing it, by reason of unsoundness of mind, is incapable of knowing the nature of the act or that he is doing what is either wrong or contrary to the law. This is as far as insanity as a defense is concerned. Now, in the next part, we will continue with the third and the last category as far as incapacity to commit crime on the part of an individual is concerned, and that is what is meant by intoxication as a defense.